enough space for your favorite stuff?
We got an easier way to remove that store when you are.
Come on, little flower, I hope you go here. Maybe. Snap. No. Do it or just do it. Okay. Let's see what's behind here.
Too busy sniffing the whiteout they'd stolen from Titan. I had to excuse them early. I just cannot get rid of this flu. And it keeps getting worse, not better.
It's been months now. Maybe it's not the flu. Flu doesn't last that long. You ought to go back to Dr. Ray.
I did, Blanche. She said I'm fine.
Get a second opinion. She did. She went to Dr. Plessinger. Well, then, you are fine. Now, you want to hear my idea? She's not fine, Blanche. Look at her. I didn't say she looks fine, but she was. She looks like hell.
Thank you, Blanche.
Oh, you know, I think in my novel, my heroine will be sick. Tragically sick, but snatched back from death by a doctor with the hands of a peasant and the soul of a pope. Oh my God, I'm rotten already. Somebody take this down.
What is she talking about?
Again, my doctor, you've got to see another doctor. Rain is not a specialist.
Yeah, but what kind of specialist do I
Remind me when I feel better to kick the crap out of her. Keep you waiting, Dorothy, but there was something I had to take care of. A famous person. Very, very famous. But I can't tell you who it is, ethics, you know. We have to be quite careful about that. But if this was win, lose, or draw, I'd draw a pound.
What?
That was a hint.
Oh, do you have my test results?
Sure do. A king, but that's it. No more clues. My lips are sealed. Oh, come on. Come on. Think about it.
I don't care who it is. It could be the king of England. I don't care.
No, England doesn't have a king. I saw your ring.
Look, all I can think about are my test results and how to keep this gown closed.
Don't worry about it. You won't be needing it. Dorothy, get dressed. You're fine.
I think so.
We run every test known to man. They're all normal. You can get dressed.
Dr. Stevens, I was always filthy, and then I came down with this flu. I can't get rid of it. I've been sick for 5 months now. I have a constant sore throat, swollen glands, fevers. My muscles ache and are weak. I'm totally exhausted all the time.
I know. You told me.
Well, maybe it bears repeating. Maybe you still think I'm Lorraine Maslansky.
Look, Dorothy, can I ask you a personal question?
Yes.
Your divorce.
Yes.
How's your social life? Do you see men?
What in the world does seeing men have to do with anything?
Well, Dorothy, we know for a fact that if people are not happy, and lonely people aren't, so they get all kinds of symptoms. Depression, fatigue, symptoms very much like the one you described.
Look, I don't think you understand, so I'm going to tell you again. I'm at a point now where I am so exhausted that sometimes I cannot speak. Literally, cannot speak. There are days when I can't get out of bed. Raising my arms to wash my hair in the shower is too exhausting for me. I can't even do that. I have heart palpitations. I can't concentrate. I forget things. I get confused.
Sorry, I don't believe you're sick. You do. You want to see this, you want to spend more money, that's fine with me. So in New York, see the man I studied with. He's the best neurologist there is. I don't know anyone better. If you have anything at all, you'll find it.
2.5 hours. I thought you died. What's wrong with you?
Nothing.
Who are you?
I'm the doctor.
We'll see about that.
Look, Mrs.
I'm Dorothy's mother. I want to know what's wrong with her. Don't tell me nothing because I know there's something wrong with her. Mother's not wrong.
Ma, I'll talk to you about it. Your daughter is fine.
100%?
100%.
Tip top?
Tip top.
Then, Mr. 100% tip top. Why the hell does she feel like hell?
Look, Ma.
Wait, I gotta hear this.
She could be functional.
Functional?
Mental.
Well. Let me tell you something, Mr. 100% tip-top mental. My daughter may be no spring chicken, and her jaw might crack when she chews. And she may have noticeable trouble digesting raw vegetables. But one thing she's not is mental. I'm smart.
Let's see here.
Ribs,
work it in anyway. What tragedy, Rose? I can't talk about it. Good. But it had to do with barbecuing elk, a big fire, and someone who lost his balance. We've been in a coma for days. The fact is, I happen to be very good at sick people. I was once a candy stripper.
That's striking.
Whatever. You know, volunteer. Oh, Dobby, I want to go to New York. How come Rose gets to go?
Blanche, whenever I don't feel well, Rose makes me feel okay.
What is she, your best friend?
Rose knows I'm sick.
Well, I know you're sick. God knows you tell me all the time. Oh, wait, Rose and I are in New York. It's going to be a great trip. You wait and see. You're going to be cured. And I'm going to get to see the big potato.
She was comforting, I didn't say she was small.
In 90 years of farming, we thought we'd seen it all. From fires and hurricanes to animal antics we could laugh about later. But we haven't seen this. So Farmers is reducing auto premiums by 25%, extending payment due dates, and expanding coverage for the delivery drivers who are carrying us through. And then we'll do the next thing. And the thing after that, until this is another thing we've seen and done.
What are you doing? You've seen everybody, nobody found anything wrong with you. And between network up and running, you're no more tests to run. I know it's boring. Your main complaint is your time. I get tired of getting old. Dr. Bud, that's not what this is. I am sick. I have to give up my job. He's a new one.
Yes, room service? Hello, this is Rose Nyland, and I'm staying here in your lovely hotel. Well, I think I need a new menu. Mine seems to be full of mistakes. For example, it says a small glass of tomato juice is $6.
Oh, room service, I'll have to party door.
Dorothy, what happened? Tell me, what did he say?
Nothing. He said exactly what everyone else said.
Oh, no! That's terrible! Oh, Dorothy, I'm so sorry. I thought surely you'd rather interesting, and everything in the world is here, but it's so tall and so crowded and so noisy and so much. I've never seen so much of everything in my whole life. I went to Bloomingdale's, the store. I swear St. Olaf could fit into it. I went to the top of the Empire State Building. You know what I don't understand? How come the fall didn't kill King Kong instantly? I mean, sure, he was big, but that's 102 stories. You look down. I know, it was a sad movie. I cried too. Every time I see it, I hope maybe this time he'll be dead. Maybe this time he won't die. But he always does. It was only a movie, Dorothy. That was really a fake gorilla.
Oh, Rose, that's not it.
What is it, Dorothy? What happened?
Maybe I am crazy. Nobody believes me. Everybody thinks I'm crazy. Maybe I am. Maybe I'm really crazy.
Dorothy, you are not crazy. I mean, you are absolutely not crazy.